have to look far, because we see this on the news every day. Violence against women and girls is unacceptably pervasive and persistent. Globally, every year, 12 million girls are married off before the age of 18. 12 million girls. The good news is advocacy on violence against women has actually heightened all across the region, but reporting, monitoring, and changing attitudes, norms, and values remains ongoing work.
We are the women who went to Beijing and participated in the great event that announced gender equality for women. We are here looking at and reviewing what we've done within these 25 years. And I'm really excited to see how much we have done in Africa. Women have really demonstrated their agency. Agency in peacemaking. If you look at what the women of the Mana River Union did when it came to making peace in that area, Liberia produced the first female president. Women have really demonstrated in so many areas that we are capable. We still have a long way to go because we started very far behind. Women have agency. Please do not think of African women as women who need this and they can't do this. Even our most illiterate women can do a lot, and they do a lot. And I'm very happy that now we have started a campaign to retire the hoe to the museum. And once that happens, you will see what African women can do with respect to food security on this continent and for the rest of the world, because we have the capacity to feed the rest of the world.
So I want to take this opportunity to thank the UN and UN Women and the AU for organizing this important meeting, which gives us an opportunity to review the implementation of the Beijing Platform for Action as we prepare ourselves to the 25th anniversary. This conference in Beijing was the largest conference ever held by the United Nations, and we women of Africa owe it so much to the support of the AU, our governments and our institutions for having managed to go to Beijing and to participate. We did contribute immensely to the Beijing Platform for Action, and that I remember that paragraph. The last paragraph on the girl child is the most important, which was a contribution by the women of Africa. The eradication of poverty too was our concern. Peace was top on our agenda. So we still want to say that the work we did in Beijing has not been completed. The homework is still there, and we do hope that this time we will be accelerating the actions to implement the Beijing Platform for Action. And as I said in Beijing, a revolution has begun. That revolution must move with high speed.
Like the other regional commissions of the United Nations, ECA has a mandate in the General Assembly Resolution 7030/133 to follow up on the full implementation of the Beijing Declaration and Platform for Action. I would like to stress 3 points today where I see opportunities that Africa needs to seize. The opportunity to embrace and harness digital technology and innovation for women's empowerment. The potential of the African continental free trade to unlock growth and productivity in general and women's economic empowerment in particular. Then the agency to make massive investment in health, in the health sector, to effectively mitigate and remedy the particular concerns of women and girls. Effective utilization of digital technology offers prospects for massive improvements in productivity and for transforming the economies in ways that can support and protect decent working conditions for everyone, but especially women. Then the celebrated African Continental Free Trade Area and its potential to unlock wealth in the region is great. Trade is an engine to economic growth, and it should present opportunities equally to men and women of Africa. Let's seize this opportunity. We just published at the United Nations Economic Commission for Africa a report entitled healthcare and economic growth in Africa. It shows that the continent is undergoing rapid demographic and urban epidemiological transitions that will have profound effects on the type, quantity, and cost of healthcare services in the future. I picked this up from the report because I found it striking that Africa is amongst the lowest densities of skilled health professionals in the world. Amongst the global threshold of 23 health professionals per 10,000 population, 13 African countries for which data was available has less than 5 professionals per 10,000 population. I would like to affirm ECA's commitment to achieve gender equality in our beloved continent for the near future.